Hello, my name's Anthony Hall, and in this Photoshop tutorial we're going to look at how we can place our own label design in different products. And I'm going to use this free image that I've got that I'll put a link to in the description, and we'll probably use a smart object and just show you how to go about, or how I would go about, changing the label. So I'm going to start by adding a new layer over here. So in the layers panel, go down to this little plus, brings up a new layer, double click the actual title, let's just give it a name of label one. And so what I want to do now is I want to make a selection of this label. So what we'll do is we'll zoom in and I'll use the pen tool. So I've done a pen tool tutorial before, so if you're not sure about how to use it, please check it out and stuff. I'll put a link below, and all I'm going to do is try and do it as simple as I can. So let's go 1, 2, 3, and you've noticed as I'm going around it's starting to fill. So this is, you have to make sure at the top, look, it's on shape for the option, the fill is whatever colour you want, and the stroke, I don't want a stroke, so I've just clicked this little option here with the red line through it to say you don't want a stroke. And then I'm using the middle mouse scroll button just to follow the line of the label, like so. And I know that the actual corners are curved, I'll sort that out after. Like so. So just control plus to zoom in a bit more. I can see I'm not up to that, I'm not completely covering the actual label. So what we do, I run the pen tool, if you hold control it changes to a solid line. This lets you click and drag the actual points. Yeah, so again, click and drag. Now if I hold down alt, it changes to this like upside down V, and then if you drag it, it brings out these handles. Same on this one, look, if I click, and it'll bring out the handles, letting me curve the edges. And again, letting me curve the edges like so. And just take your time, go around using the actual control to move and then alt to manipulate the handles, look, on it and so on. So like I have done. Okay, if you want to add an extra point, you can just click in between, control, move it down, let's put one over here, control, pull it down. So you slowly fill in that area. Let's control, let's go up to here and have a look. So this one could do using, so I'm just going to move it to the corner with the control, then I'm going to alt and bend that corner a little bit, scroll to the side again, let's control, and then let's, in fact, let's add one here because it's not covering it. And again, I mean, I suppose I would probably take, if I was doing this for anything client wise, I would be taking my time. Oops, moved the whole lot there. A lot more. Now to check it, let's control and zero and just click on the background. And so you can see it's not perfectly filled in. And so let's zoom back in on this area, like so, and then let's go back to the pen tool while we're on the layer, and then let's click, and then we can go back in nice and close. And again, I'm just using the control to move the edges and stuff. And I'm using control minus and plus to zoom in and out, by the way. And then let's just click off that. And again, I still need to clean some of this edges up. So I'll do that a bit later, because I want to jump onto the next bit, because you can go back and do it if you want. But it's up to you if you want to clean it up now. Which, once you're happy with the actual label itself or the shape, what we're going to do is go back over to our actual layer it's on, and we're going to right mouse click, and there's an option that says convert to smart object. So we'll click that, and you get this little icon in the corner. So what that's done is it's going to make, as a smart object, it means we can open this shape up separate in a separate document that's linked to this, change it, and it will update in here for us. So if I double click it, the shape appears here, and that's now linked to that. So if I do anything to this layer, it will, as long as I save it, like Control S, it will update in here. So let's add something to that. Let's do that. So let's open up some documents. I've got some different images here. So let's open this up. So this is like a textured paper, which I'll put the link if you want it, but it's got this writing on. So let's use the rectangle marquee tool. Let's just select an area with a nice area around it, and then we'll go to edit, fill. We're going to put it on contents aware, because I want it to fill and get rid of this black area, this writing, using the area around it. So press OK, and there we have it. It's a little bit smudgy here and there, but I can live with that. I'm only using it as a background. So next, we can drag and drop it in, or we can select it. Depends on how big this image is. It's going to be a lot bigger than this image. So when I actually, so it is quite bigger than the that we need. So let's just control T, and let's drag it down so we can find the corners. So once we've found the corners, if we hold shift and drag from the corners down, let's quickly free transform this so it's fitting roughly the area. In fact, while we're on it, let's rotate it and let's get it roughly so it's kind of running through the image like that. So double click when you're happy. Next, what I want to do is I want to get rid of this outside area, because I only want it to be the same size as this, because if we overlap it, it'll take that area through, because the whole document is literally linked to this. So to do that, we just literally hover over the little thumbnail of layer one, hold control so it switches to this little square, click it so it selects a square, then go to select inverse, turn on the layer back again, and then backspace or delete, and you'll get that kind of get rid of all that information there. So let's control D to drop the selection, and then if you control and S to save it and switch back to the wine bottle, you'll notice it's updated. So now that we've got our texture onto our actual bottle, which we can jump back through to here, which is obviously our label one PSB. Let's just get rid of that. We don't want that now. And let's see what else we can do with this. So I don't need that. I only need the actual label, that actual layer, just as to see where the original shape is, so I know where the label is. So now let's go and add another image. Just this one. And again, I'll drop all these images, links to them, in the description. And let's shrink this down. Let's place this and come up with some kind of quick label. Something like that, we'll say. So if I just save this and jump over, you can see it's outside of the actual option. So again, let's just control and click on layer one and invert it, And then when I'm on layer 2, just put backspace so we get rid of it information. And again, if you want to at this stage, you could go and have a play around with the overlays and see if any of the overlays make it look nicer. But again, it's completely up to you. That one looks all right. So if we save it, jump back through. Make sure I saved it. There we go. And let's just pull this out. And let's put it here. So whatever I do to this now, as long as I go Control S, it will update. So let's say, for instance, I wanted to let's put some text on it. So let's just put in wine. Okay, so text tool, leaving it on the default. I'm not even sure why I'm on that one. And then let's move it into place. We can edit, transform, rotate it, place it where you want. Could do. Make sure Control S, and it will update here. Look, so you can see what you're actually doing on it. Another thing we could probably do is let's say this layer one here. Let's duplicate it. Turn off the original. Let's say we wanted to change the color. So image adjustment hue saturate. Let's colorize it. Let's choose a pinky color, something like that. And then we could also maybe see if we can find an overlay. Don't feel there's nothing to really overlay underneath, actually thinking about it. I tell you what we could do is we could go to original layer. Let's come over to your actual toolbar, click on the fourth tool, magic one, make sure you're on the little flower label, click the white centered bit, and then we're just going to Control X and Control V to cut and paste it onto its own layer. And let's just move it roughly into place. You can use your arrow keys while on the move tool. Let's just fade that down to about, I don't know, 65%, so it's got like a pinky area in the background. Then let's see if we can find an overlay, something like that. So let's save that. And then it updates here, look, as well. I mean, there are other things you can do. So if you notice here, you've got this light. Now, depending on how detailed or glossy the actual images, you might get that. I mean, if we go back to the original one and turn that layer off, remember that layer there is this here. I can't really see it going through this there, but you could do something like that if you want. You could come in here, you could create a new layer, maybe color in some highlights if you want. I mean, you could say go over to your toolbar, let's use the actual burn tool, which kind of adds like a burn to it. I'm on 30% exposure, so I'm like burning the sides, so it might give the illusion slightly of it going around the corner, the darker area. So let's just save that, and again it's kind of done it. And again, if you switch to color dodge, and I've got this maybe set up here, look, when you with your actual brush make it a certain size, certain shape, and this will suck the actual color out. So roughly around here you could add a couple of really bad light streaks. Let me just show you what I mean dead quickly. So let's say that was a light streak, and then we saved it, and it adds it there, look. But again, I've done it quite quickly and it's not amazing, so we can reduce some of that like so. But it's as easy as that. We can put these in a folder in this here now, and we could actually again, let's jump back, change the color to that, save it, and it's updated here. And again, you could work into it, like I said, you could like make it blend in a little bit more, manipulate it with the pen tool, and so on and so forth. But that's a quick look at how I would maybe make up a mock-up of a label that I could then come in to the mock-up, the smart layer, and start changing and adding stuff to it as I want, when I want. And obviously it's quite easy once you get into it, and you can use it for all different products. You just got to make the area you want as the edit. So hope this tutorial's been useful. Please share and subscribe. Look out for my next tutorial.